So welcome to my class. We are doing unit 3, in which we are doing tools, unit 3 tools, and their statistical tools and their interpretation. And in that we finish with measures of central tendency. And now we are doing measures of dispersion. That means how much does the value move away from the average? That's particularly. Now look at this. Now here we have methods of measuring dispersion. We finished with range, we finished with quartile deviation. We are doing mean deviation, and mean deviation also we finished with the two series, that is the individual and the discrete. And in this we are doing the continuous series. And in the continuous series, we first can either work out the average with the mean or with median. We finished with mean. In the previous class, we worked out the first we found out the mean, and from there then we worked out the mean deviation from the mean. But in that I just wanted to tell you that one mistake that I made was that 50 to 60 midpoint, I've written 50, so just make that correction. It is 55, and then the mean was 29, and I wrote from 50 minus 29. So please, that correction has to be done. But anyways, so I'll point it out there also. I was just going through that video and I saw that. Okay, now coming back to the lesson, we are going to find out mean deviation in the continuous series with the help of this average, median. So step one, we'll calculate the midpoints as L1 plus L2 divided by 2 of each class interval. Then it becomes like a discrete series. Okay, now, and then you find out the median. You find out median, okay? So we find out the median. Okay, so median is what? Now in that, what we'll do is, first we'll find out in which median class it is. The size of the median class, how do we find out? So we find out as n by 2th item. Okay, and then once you do that, it will be L1 plus n by 2 minus CF upon F into I, which we will do as we know how to work out the median. Okay, now let's consider this. This is a numerical that we are going to do to find out the mean deviation. Okay, now in this, 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70. And these are the frequencies, 8, 12, 10, 8, 3, 2 and 7. Now what we must do here is you have to find out the cumulative frequencies. So 8 plus 12 is 20, 20 plus 10 is 30, 30 and 8. We're going on accumulating the frequencies, 38. 38 plus 3 is 41, 41 plus 2 is 43, 43 plus 7 is 50. So now where does median lie? Size of n by 2th item, that is 50 divided by 2th item is the 25th item. So where does the 25th item lie? Here. Okay, so corresponding to that, what do you get? The class interval, median lies in the class interval between 20 to 30. Now, so median lies in the size of, first we found out that, now what is here? So this is, you take up L1, that means lower limit of the class interval. So it is between 20 to 30, right? So where is L1 now? L1 is 20. Then what do you get? Just put the values. CF coming before that, 10 upon the frequency here, 10. Just remember one thing, these should add up to 30. Only then, the previous cumulative frequency and the frequency, if you add them up, it should be equal to the cumulative frequency of the median class, that is 30. So if you, in case you forget, this is one thing you have to remember. Once again, once you do n by 2 minus CF, CF means previous, and frequency is the frequency of the median class. So if you add them up together, then it becomes the cumulative frequency of the class interval in which the median lies, that is 30. All right, that is just in case you forget sometimes. So into I is the class interval 10. So we get, so median works out to be 25. So now we go ahead, we first find out the mid values. So what are the mid values? It is 0 plus 10 divided by 2, 5, 10 plus 20 is 15, 20 and 30 is 25, etc. So you come to this. So now next is, you take the mid values and you minus the median then, whatever median you got. So median is 25. So 5 minus 25 is 20, 15 minus 25 is 10, 25 minus 25 is 0, 35 minus 25 is 10. Now what is 25? Median. So 45 is a mid value. So mid value of this class interval. So the next mid value is 55 minus 25, 30. The last is 65 minus 25, and this is how you get. Now you have to take the frequencies and the deviations that you worked out. Okay, so this is how we get. So what is that? 20 into 8 is 160, 10 into 50, 12 into 10 is 120, and this is 0, 8 into 10 is 80, and so on. So once you multiply each corresponding frequency with the deviations that you worked out from the median, you are able to get each of these. Then you add them up. So once you add them up, what do you get? 760 f into d, sigma f into d. So mean deviation is, mean deviation by median is equal to sigma f d upon f. So just write down the values here. 760 and 50 upon 50 is equal to 15.2. So coefficient, now that is a mean deviation from median. That is the answer. Now, we are interested in finding out what is the, sometimes you get a question as, what is the coefficient of mean deviation in this? So, coefficient of mean deviation by median is mean deviation from median divided by the median. So, 15.2 divided by 25. So, what you get is 0.608. So, with that, again, let me just repeat myself that you have to do this in your notebook, and please open your books and do that. Do an exercise or do the illustration given in your book, and then do one numerical from the from your textbook and see, it'll stay with you. Okay.